Welcome to the short tutorial on installing Lansweeper. This video tutorial covers the easy install, which is sufficient for most users with up to 1,000 assets. When performing an easy install, the database will be set up on the Microsoft SQL Compact Database Server, and the Lansweeper service, database, and web console will be installed on the same machine. Let's start the installation. First things first, download the latest installer from our website, lansweeper.com, and run it on the Windows computer you want to install Lansweeper on. Hit the Next button. Make sure you go over the license agreements and hit I agree to accept and continue the installation. Select the Easy Install option and hit Next. The web console will automatically be installed under the first available port, but you can choose custom ports if you prefer. Hit Next to continue. Optionally, you can choose a custom folder to install Lansweeper under. Hit Install to proceed. This will install the web console under IIS Express and the database under Microsoft SQL Compact. If you want to receive the latest Lansweeper news, solutions, and updates, enter a name and email address to subscribe to our newsletter. Hit Finish to close the installer. Once installed, you can access the web console by double-clicking the Lansweeper desktop icon. You'll be presented with the first run wizard, which allows you to set up scanning and configure some basic options. These settings can always be adjusted later. By default, Lansweeper will automatically detect the IP range in which you are currently located. You can submit a different IP range if required. Hit Next to continue. Using domain or workgroup scanning, Lansweeper will scan the Windows computers as they come online. It also scans domain users configured in Active Directory. Hit Next to proceed. Lansweeper uses administrative credentials to access and pull data from your computers. It is important to note that your credentials are always encrypted and stored locally. Lansweeper never sends them across the network or internet. Your credentials must have admin privileges on your computers, and for scanning domain computers and users, read only access to Active Directory. Hit Next to continue. For scanning network devices such as printers and switches, enter an SNMP community string. The default string is public, which is commonly used by network devices for read-only access, but can be different for your network. Hit Next to proceed. If you will be scanning Linux, Unix, or Mac computers, enter an SSH username and password. Hit Next to continue. If you have any VMware servers in your network, enter a username and password with read-only access to the Managed Object Browser. Hit Next to proceed. Select the date format you'd like to use throughout the Lansweeper web console and hit Finish. At this point, Lansweeper will automatically start scanning your network. Hit Continue to immediately proceed to the web console while scans are taking place in the background. The results from your initial discovery can be consulted by clicking Assets in the top menu. Click on a specific asset to catch a glimpse of the information Lansweeper was able to retrieve. But this is just the tip of the iceberg. Ready to get started? You will find more information below to help you set up Lansweeper and discover everything it has to offer. Check out these other videos and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.